glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Explosive offenses on virtually every campus in the Pac-12. Time to establish a little pecking order with this early season matchup in the Pac-12. That does it for us here on the NCAA College Football pregame show. Enjoy the game. We'll see you at the half.
Here in Pasadena. And now let's head down to the coin toss, brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Flynn is on the field to kick this one off, and everyone in the stadium is ready for this game to get started.
He'll return it from the 6. He's out to the 30, and he's tackled to the 33-yard line.
Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it.
Makes the catch, and look out. And down he goes at the 41.
Page on the tackle at the 41-yard line. That makes it second and two.
He's got an opening. Tackled after a decent pickup.
It's a nice read by the quarterback to keep the ball and pick up some yardage.
Fights forward to about the 46. Here's an opening. That's a great tackle at the 46.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That'll bring up 32.
Caught, open field, and they push him out around the 35-yard line.
When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want them.
I'm coming after you. And he hits him hard at the 38-yard line. The play of this defensive end.
This is just solid run defense here. They get a great push up front, not allowing the runner to have much room to work with. And at the end, they're able to wrap him up.
From the 38-yard line, it's second down. And they get nice yardage on that run. Anderson gains about 4 yards on the play.
That'll bring up third and eight.
Under pressure, he heaves it to the end zone, and he's got it, touchdown. Catch and a big touchdown from the tight end.
I'll tell you, this tight end is a big-time football player. He might like to talk a little bit out there on the field, but he has the type of game to back it up.
He makes the PAT. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
The Demon Deacons came into the game ranked 9th. After the bitterly disappointing loss, how far will the Pollsters move them down? And for Wake Forest, they've dropped 2 straight. The Broncos roll by 19. Well, that's an absolutely shocking upset. You can count on that one to turn the poles upside down when they're released.
They line up to kick this one away. Benjamin has it at the five. Across midfield. And he's tackled at the 39.
Well, the crowd has been waiting for him all day. Hayden's big playability about to be on display in front of the home crowd here. He's set to take his first snap as he brings the offense out, Kurt.
And, Brad, this kid's reputation precedes him. The entire offense is designed around him. As his performance goes, so will his team. So let's see what he can do in front of this big crowd. Just a complete leader.
Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete.
This is a well-designed play by the offensive coordinator. Everything really seemed to be working just fine, except for the quarterback. He's got to throw a better football.
From the 39-yard line, second down. Caught with room to work. And he's tackled right around the 30. Tackle made at about the 17-yard line.
And created the whole thing with his feet. Boy, was that fun to watch or what?
We'll be tied with the extra point. And he converts the extra point. A four-play, 39-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. UCLA is ready to kick it away. Doty fields it at the 7. He's tackled at the 29.
This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over.
Fires quickly to the tight end. Brought down at the 32.
Really excited to watch this guy grow with this defense. That was his first tackle, but I guarantee you, he's got hundreds more coming. From their own 30-yard line. Down.
Tackle. Yard line.
Page with the tackle at the 40-yard line.
Easy.
Here comes the pressure. Hauls it in as he's pushed out of bounds. Excellent play as the quarterback found his receiver for a big game.
Well, give credit here to the receiver for finding that seam and coming up with a nice gain for the offense.
Taken down at the 42-yard line. Gets it out. He's met immediately. A 4-yard loss.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
And once again, they'll come to the line, try to convert on third down. It's a fumble. Picks up the fumble. He's taken down right around the 48-yard line.
after the sack. It's now fourth and long. The Rams saw one of their top players go down earlier, but it looks like he's going to be able to get back in there. Swanson is waiting for the snap. Tackle at the 22-yard line. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. Nice run up the middle. Played one quarter. We get a tie game at 7-7. Back to the action here in the second quarter. It's been a good one and a tight one at this point. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That makes it third and three.
I got one.
And they make the stop around the 38-yard line.
Third down,
and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Now he tries to buy some time. He's at the 40. He's tackled the 37-yard line.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
And they hit him in the backfield.
Those linebackers do a great job of stopping the run, but they need to be careful of the play action pass. You can easily get fooled and give up some big yards through the air.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. He's scrambling. And down he goes, right around the 14-yard line. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
The penetration by the defense was so good on that play. Then it didn't matter who the ball carrier was. Anyone would have been brought down for a loss.
So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. UCLA could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks away, and the field goal is good. Glenn is lined up to kick this one off. He's to the 20.
And down he goes at the 28.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Got some open field. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
That play was over before it got started. That was just a case of the offensive line getting beat at the snap of the ball.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. To the tight end, and that ball's incomplete. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on a pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
Yellow three.
They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one.
He dropped it. And he's taken down at the 42.
Hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. UCLA is up a field goal. Now he's scrambling. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. And he's tackled around the 41-yard line.
I'm telling you, quarterbacks who can run the ball are so hard to stop. You have to scheme around them, which takes the best coverages out of your defensive playbook.
They bring him down in the backfield.
That is just a great play getting into the backfield. This guy is so quick that the ball carrier never had a chance.
Second and 14. Ball on the 45-yard line. And he's immediately tackled. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Fights forwards about the 19. Gordon comes away with about 2 yards on a little draw play.
And that was the sophomore linebacker there who was able to get in and make that tackle.
From the 19-yard line, second down.
They'll drop him for a loss.
Loss of 1 yard on the play. That'll make it third and nine.
The cavalry's coming, and he is drilled at the 30-yard line.
Loss of 10 yards on the play. That makes it fourth and long.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. They'll spread the field with five wide.
They decided to go for it, but the defense slammed the door on them. That's the definition of coming through when it matters most.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Taken back 3 yards.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Second down, 13 yards to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. We've played a half of football. The Bruins in front, 10-7.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. What a terrific first half. This is everything we anticipated this game being. And we're going to be riveted to this game, I feel like, David, in the second half, anticipating a terrific finish.
It's fun. It's living up to the hype every single time. We can't even turn the channel here. We got it on the big screen, on the big 60-inch. Yes, it's quite nice, by the way, too. The weather's nice and warm. It's beautiful. Got some chips. We're opening them up a little bit. But great game, living up to the hype. It definitely feels like both teams are evenly matched. It feels like it can go either way. It feels like it's going to come down to the wire. And the only thing I hope it doesn't come down to is a kicker. Please don't come down to a kick in the end. Both these teams playing great D, playing great O, you know, physical, you know, pounding on each other, making big plays. Don't come down to a finesse kick by like a soccer player, please.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes three or four axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He's to the 20. Across the 30. He's taken down at the 36-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. UCLA holds a field goal lead. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Tries to set up a screen for the wide receiver. Tackle made around the 42-yard line.
That'll make it 35.
That's a great tackle at the 43-yard line. Back to the line, maybe a yard on the pass.
This was just a little dump-off pass to the halfback, but it was very well defended, keeping them from moving the ball very far downfield.
The defense has everybody on. I think they're going to come after this one. And he muffed it.
I know I'd be nervous with 11 guys sprinting down the field at me, but the first job of a return man is to catch the ball.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. And they'll get him in the backfield. From their own 20-yard line, second down. Gives it off. Good tackle there in space.
It's amazing the read and recognition skills of these linebackers. They just always seem to have a beat on the play.
It's second and 15. Ball on the 29-yard line. I got you. Got a man. Watch
reach out here. And he shoved out of bounds around the 35-yard line.
6 yards. Third down.
He zips it out to the right. He's hit and taken down.
That makes it first and 10.
Looks for the tight end, but they can't hook up. And there wasn't anyone in the vicinity.
I think the ball just slipped out on him.
From the 36-yard line. It's second down. Five wide. Brought down around the 27-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards. That'll make it third and one.
In the shotgun and five wide outs. Pulls it in and gets out of bounds.
That's the third time they've converted on third down on this drive. When you can stay on the field in these kind of situations, you're doing something right.
And all their DBs in there to match up against the five wide set.
Easy.
And he throws it away. It's second and 10. Ball on the 22. A complete to the halfback over the middle. Tackle around the 24-yard line.
That brings us third and 12.
So again a third down as the offense lines up. Is one for the end zone. Touchdown, Colorado State.
Great effort by the wide receiver. And not to take anything away from the quarterback, but the wide receiver made this play.
It was a pretty simple route, but they run it to perfection for the score. And he converts the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 27. Colorado State's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers. The way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage, I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. Run down after a nice run up the middle. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. They'll bring him down around the 46-yard line. Goes for about a yard, but that's it.
That brings up second and 9.
Tight right.
He's taken down at the 27-yard line.
Back, 56,
the stop at the 24.
Gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and seven.
And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. Galloway gains about 5 yards on the play.
That'll bring up third and two.
And it looks like this one's going to come down to the final quarter. 14-10, Rams. Going to determine this one. Tight ball game. Action set to start here in the fourth quarter. That's a huge, huge stop here in the fourth quarter. They've got the lead. They're going to get the football back, but there's still a lot of ball left. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down.
It's always a gamble going for it with so many yards to come up with. But when you're behind, sometimes you have to take risks to get back into a ball game.
The offense just wasn't able to make a play. The defense was really clutch right there. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Colorado State is up by four. Big opening, and they push him out at the 37.
Game 41, that makes it first and 10.
Around the 19-yard line. And a big run on third down.
Anytime you can move the ball like this, you're putting a lot of pressure on that defense.
He's going to try and scramble. They bring him down.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
Second down and 11. Ball on the 20. And he's taken down around the 10-yard line. They complete. Good for 10.
Third down.
That's the second time that this defense has given up a first down on third down. You work so hard as a defense to get an offense to third down. Get them there, you've got to be able to have somebody step up and make a big play, whether it's a defensive tackle slipping through a block, a linebacker shooting.
Fires quickly, and they got it. Touchdown.
extra point. Reese Davis is standing by with this update. Reese?
The Tigers were ranked number 13. They took care of business, and they should hold their spot next week. There was never any room to breathe in this game. Clemson takes it by 5.
Our score, 21-10. Swanson has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. Taken at the 5. Tackle at the 31.
Well, this is a very competitive game. Just when you think one team has gained the advantage or the momentum, the other team comes fighting back, and it's going back and forth. This is almost like a basketball game.
So they're just about set to get the game going again. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Scrambling around. Decides to slide. Now he's scrambling. And down he goes. Right around the 46-yard line. Hit before it could go anywhere.
If they're going to have any chance to pull this one out, they'll need some more fine efforts like the one on that catch.
Now he tries to buy some time. And he's tackled at the 24-yard line. To the end zone. And they couldn't hook up on that one. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 18.
Mike 56, Mike 56.
Fires out quickly to the tailback. Tackle made at about the 21.
Gain of 3 on the play. That'll make it 4th and 2.
Short yardage situation, and the offense is in the jumbo package. Touchdown, Bruins. Late in the fourth quarter now, and with that score, this game's a one-possession ball game, and it's really going to get tense from here on out. And the quarterback stays on the field as they try for the two-point conversion. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. He's got the 2. And down he goes at the 43. This is where the offense has to come to the forefront. They work all week for situations like this. They've got the lead, they've got a chance to add to it, and that'd mean a victory. He's got an opening. He's at the 30. Gets out to around the 22.
Well, the execution of this offense has been on display here in this drive. They know what they needed to do, and that's pick up the first down, work the clock, and finish this game off. And with that first down, they may have done it.
First and 10. Ball on the 22-yard line. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. A 2-yard run by the halfback. The Bruins are going to call their second timeout. Makes it out to about the 10. What a critical first down as time ticks away.
Huge, huge first down. The defense desperately needed a stop there.
From the 10-yard line, first down. Nothing more demoralizing for a defense than seeing the opposing quarterback take a knee. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. A great game here today in a tight one.
Colorado State 21, UCLA 18.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.